One.
Hi, Hi Grandpa. Grandpa.
We have a question for you. What's your
favorite book of all time?
Well, hello, Cameron and James. You asked your grandpa what his favorite book was. And that created a bit of a problem, you see, because I like a lot of books. You know, I have a big, big, big library, and there's lots of books. So what I did is my answer to you would be, my favorite color would be the rainbow, you see. And the rainbow has seven colors. So I've chosen just seven books out of my library, and I hope that you're going to enjoy them. Okay, so here's the first book. This one's called The Uses of the Past. And it's a story about the past worlds that existed. And in those worlds, for instance, how we use the past is that we build our post office so they look like Roman buildings. Okay, we build our banks so they look like Roman buildings. So those one physical use. The other way we use the past is in our law. English common law is based upon Roman law, and Roman law in turn is based upon Babylonian law. Also, the idea of how we use the past is the idea of fair play, or the idea that light will triumph over darkness. So that's an interesting book to read. And it's heavy duty, maybe a little too heavy for you now, but I'm darn sure someday you'll enjoy it. The Uses of the Past. The other one that's really interesting is a big heavy one. And this is a book called English Literature. You see how thick it is? And this is a survey, English literature and its background of the English language. And so the first sort of written big deal story, like Homer's Iliad type of thing, and the Trojan Wars in English was a story about Beowulf. And you should maybe look up about Beowulf. And then it moves on to the various types of poetry, let's say Augustan and Romance. It goes on to the theater. It goes on to books that have been written that are wonderful and very interesting. So that's the second choice. The third one is, you know, I like words. So here's a super duper book called The Roots of English. And this tells you the story of English words. And you remember when we were in Florida, we looked at and we talked about the days of the week and where they got its name. Well, there's a lot of stuff in here like that. So for instance, the Greeks, when you say hello to them, they say Kali. And Kali means beautiful. And it's come into the English language in the words when we have beautiful writing, we have calligraphy. And if we have a beautiful body and we exercise, we have calisthenics. And so we get to have a beautiful body. Okay. The opposite of that is caco. And caco is a word that you probably know. And it's one of the most ancient words in the world. It really comes from caca. And if I say caca, you know what caca is. Okay. And if I said this way back when the Greeks were around and the Romans, they'd know. Or if I told them in India, they'd know what caca is. Well, that word comes down to us in cacophony, meaning ugly sound. So this book here tells you stories like that. The one that I really like as well, you know how I am about Greeks. This is Greek as a Treat. And it tells you what the Greeks are all about and what they think and that sort of thing, and how they got around to creating gods and their relationship and the Olympic Games and that sort of thing. Another book that's interesting, it's called The Geography of Genius. And why did geniuses all of a sudden appear in the time of the Greeks or in the time of the Renaissance in the 14th century? Or like right now in Silicon Valley. You know, is it the water? Is it the air? Is it the education? What is it that creates geniuses? Okay. Now, a lot of the books I have here are, of course, like this one. This is the giant book of useless information. And there's a lot of useless information in the library, but there's a lot of great information. I learned about things. You remember Grandpa told you that the unquestioned life isn't worth living? Well, that caused me always throughout my life to ask questions. And I was asked questions of people, and if I couldn't get an answer there, I'd go to books. But I got a lot of useless information too, but a lot of great information. This is before Google, where you could look up anything like that. But this, I still have to touch things, whereas electronically, you guys can bounce around. Now, your grandpa's a little bit older than you right now. In fact, this year I'm going to be 80 years old. Who knew? And so, again, I'm asking the question, what is it like to be old, and what's the meaning of life? And this book here is called The Travels with Epicurus. And it's about a man in his 70s, and he wants to find out what life is all about at the tail end of life. And so he goes to a Greek island, and there he contemplates his navel, as it were, and thinks about the way the world works. And he comes back and he feels refreshed. And his attitude is my attitude now, I share with him. It's the autumn of my life. I'm going to sit in a park bench and enjoy myself and have you guys around and just enjoy. I don't have to strive to do anything. I don't have to try to be young and run a mile or something like that. I just have to enjoy myself. Pleasure and happiness. So that's The Travels with Epicurus. So you asked me about books. There, you got the story of books. Oh, there's one more I know you'll love. You're going to have to look hard for this one. It's called The Book of Poo. Yes. Okay. So you see if you can find that. So there's some books for you. I hope you enjoy my little blurb. And I'd love to see you, and big hugs and kisses from your grandpa. Take care. Ciao.